Elon Musk details Tesla's humanoid robot after these proof-of-concept images. Tesla's humanoid robot, codenamed Optimus, has a target weight of 125 pounds and is slated to be unveiled at the end of this month. Tesla's Optimus humanoid robot is being engineered to automate repetitive tasks with the goal of creating a future where physical labor will not be required, but rather be a choice. Elon Musk said that the robot will eventually impact the labor force in a way that creates jobs instead of eliminating them. Musk said that the robot will be capable of performing extremely difficult and complex tasks, such as being able to obey an order to pick up a bolt and attach it to a machine with a wrench. While it seems to be a relatively mindless task for a human, it is exceedingly difficult for a robot to perform a general task in an uncontrolled environment using fine motor skills, making this seemingly mundane task an extremely impressive feat. The Tesla humanoid robot is also designed to be friendly and help people navigate the world, as well as perform general tasks for humans with its 45-pound carrying capacity. Also, with its maximum speed of just 5 miles per hour and a lifting capacity of only 10 pounds using outstretched arms, it will not pose as any sort of military or industrial threat. It is also said to have human-level hands, a screen for useful information and 40 electromechanical actuators for fluid movement, with 12 in its arms, 2 in its neck, 2 in its torso, 12 in its legs, and 12 in its hands. The Optimus humanoid robot will be able to deadlift a moderately impressive 150 pounds. Elon Musk expounded on safety by saying the robot was being designed in such a way that it is at a mechanical and physical level of power and speed that you can easily run away from, making it easy to overwhelm if necessary. Elon Musk stated that Tesla is undoubtedly the largest robotics company in the world, arguing that its cars are already semi-sentient robots with wheels. He went on to say that with the full self-driving computer, the inference engine on the car, various neural networks, recognizing the world, understanding how to navigate through the world, and so on, it also makes sense to put these features into a humanoid form. The Optimus humanoid robot will utilize Tesla's fully self-driving computer, autopilot cameras, and a full suite of artificial intelligence tools, including neural net planning, object detection, labeling, and simulation capability. While some onlookers have noted that Tesla's full self-driving feature has been promised for many years, Elon Musk went out of the way to assure people who were afraid of a Terminator situation that Tesla's Optimus humanoid robot would not be dangerous. As if Tesla isn't busy enough creating fully self-driving cars or cars with half-year waitlists, CEO Elon Musk says there should be a prototype for the Tesla humanoid robot sometime in 2023. This doesn't seem like a lot of certainty, and history has shown that it's not wise to heavily rely on Tesla's or Elon Musk's timelines. On the flip side, history has also shown that it's not wise to bet against the company or its capability to innovate either, so only time will tell when it comes to the Optimus humanoid robot. Meta is developing artificial intelligence that can decode brainwaves to understand the words someone is hearing. An artificial intelligence created by Meta, the owner of Facebook, can hear what someone is saying to them by scanning their brainwaves. The researchers are trying to understand the brain's workings, and Meta artificial intelligence has monitored the brain activity in 169 healthy adults. They listened to stories and heard words being read aloud, while various equipment, such as electrodes, were attached to their heads. Researchers then used the data to build the artificial intelligence model in order to identify the brain's patterns. They wanted the algorithm to hear the participants and ascertain their listening habits based on the magnetic and electrical activity in their brains. While this AI software is still in its early stages of development, the technology would have many potential use cases. Meta does not intend to commercialize this technology immediately, but it could be an initial step towards reading nonverbal thoughts and enabling people to communicate better with other humans and a computer. A researcher at the Facebook Artificial Intelligence Research Lab commented that this is especially beneficial for people who have a range of conditions that impair communication, such as anoxia and traumatic brain injury. This technology is already available in some formats. Researchers can use electrodes to monitor the motor parts of a patient's brain and decode their neural activity. This allows them to communicate with the outside world, but inserting electrodes inside a patient's brain can be quite invasive. Facebook's AI researchers are therefore trying to find a better way to capture brain activity without having to invasively probe the brain with electrodes, which requires a surgical procedure. Facebook's AI researchers are therefore trying to find a better way to capture brain activity without having to invasively probe the brain with electrodes, which requires a surgical procedure. There still remain several challenges ahead in this research, including the fact that the electrodes are currently quite far away from the brain, causing the detected brain signals to be extremely noisy. The skull and skin could also affect the brainwave signals that the researchers receive, which makes their non-invasive approach even more challenging. The second issue the researchers are still facing is the issue of properly and reliably decoding the brainwaves into human language. All in all, the researchers have their work cut out for them. Intel Labs introduces new approach to neural network-based object learning. In collaboration with the Technical University of Munich and the Italian Institute of Technology, Intel Labs has developed a new method for neural network-based object training. This new approach is specifically targeted at future robotics applications, such as robotic assistants that interact in unconstrained environments. These situations include healthcare and logistics. This research could be crucial to improving the manufacturing and service capabilities of future robots. The research is further detailed in a paper titled Interactive Continual Learning for Robots. A neuromorphic approach, which won the Best Paper Award at the 2022 International Conference on Neuromorphic Systems, hosted by Oak Ridge National Laboratory. Neuromorphic computation is used to create interactive learning objects that allow robots to find new objects. Researchers used the models to demonstrate interactive learning using the Loihi neuromorphic chips. They were able to consume up to 175x less power when learning new objects instances. They were also able to achieve similar speed and accuracy as conventional methods that use CPUs. Researchers were able to achieve this feat by using a Loihi-based spiking neural network architecture. This allows for the localization of object learning in one layer of plastic synapses. The network was able to accommodate different object views by recruiting additional neurons as needed. This allowed the learning process to take place independently while still being influenced by the user. Intel Labs is a leader within the field of neuromorphic computer research. They work to help realize neuromorphic computing's goal of enabling next-generation intelligent devices and autonomous systems. Neuromorphic computing follows the principles of biological neural computation and relies on innovative algorithmic approaches to mimic the human brain and its interactions with the world. Neuromorphic computing, an innovative architectural approach to autonomous AI solutions, will power future self-learning and energy-efficient solutions. It has been used in many areas such as robotics, sensors, and healthcare. Anyways, make sure to subscribe to our channel for the latest news in artificial intelligence, cutting-edge robotics, and brain-computer interface. And thanks for watching.